Alright, so I already added all of my salt to my flour and then added that, and you want to add it all at once because this isn't supposed to be very smooth. We want it to be a little bit lumpy. It's not like we're making a, velvet cupcake of some sort.
No. Unlike popular belief, we want this to be lumpy, okay?
It adds another bit of texture to it, and it's really good.
So the lumpy batter looks like this.
It's not all perfect and smooth. It's got kind of a lumpiness to it. And then we cooked our apples on the stove with the cinnamon sugar and butter until they're just a little bit soft but not soggy.
And if the apples are still hard by now, that means what? If they're still hard, they're undercooked because of what? What happened there? Someone cut it too big or not enough heat. All right, so now you're learning how to troubleshoot. All
right, and
now
then once you've made your lumpy batter, you're going to spread them all out through the bottom of the pan, which is already done. You're going to pour your batter over them, and this is where having a rubber spatula helps to get all of the goodies inside. And we're just going to put it in after we've poured it all over our apples. We're going to put it in the oven for 20 to 25 minutes and bake it. And that is how we make a delicious...
Making sure every bite's a delight. We're sticking ours in the convection oven. Regular oven is 20 to 25. Convection is definitely 15. Yes. We're set. Part two, pancake, oven pancake. And as you saw, maybe then it was pretty high up there, right? And now she's gonna finish it up. And the big thing I wanna warn you.
Yeah. Keep the hot pad on there.
It's only about 500 degrees hot. Only.
So we just want to tap the strainer this and get a nice drizzling of powdered sugar on top.
Is it the first time we're using powdered sugar?
Yes.
Oh, okay. So this is what we use.
So we get the powdered sugar in the box. You just put it in a sieve or a strainer, and you just want to tap your hand, just like when we sifted the flour.
Absolutely.
So just like that.
And we keep it on a plate so it's not dripping messy everywhere. And then we put it on a full sheet pan over here, so we keep this nice and clean.
Syrup, whatever. All right. So you can get kind of fun with this. You just want to open it a little bit.
Just a little bit. If you open it the spout too much, then you're going to get thick lines. We want thin lines. Look how good that looks.
We can go back the other way too.
Yes, definitely go the other way too. Then we're going to cut it like a pie.
Alright, so today you guys can just cut it up for however many people are in your
Eat it all up. So good.
Cut.
If you don't like apples, make it with bananas, make it with berries. Make it during your winter break. Bound to put a smile on anybody's face. So good. And I'm going to eat another one.
All right.
So we have our offset spatula here.
Thank you.
That looks perfect. Nice presentation. Watch out for your dotted lines because then, might be hard to out of the pan.
All right. So now you're just going to do like with the pie. Get nice and
nice.
This is our oven pancake.